हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम अनीता मिश्रा, योर कंप्यूटर टीचर। अगेन वेलकम यू ऑल इन ई क्लास। दिस वीडियो इज फॉर स्टैंडर्ड 4। नाउ लेट्स गो about today's topic, and today's topic is working with Windows, which is chapter 4 in your computer book. Now let's start the chapter. Windows 7. What is Windows? As we know that Windows is an operating system. It is a graphical user interface. It is very user friendly. That's why it is the most powerful operating system. Windows operating system is the interface between the user and computer. It is developed by Microsoft, a world leading software company, founded by Bill Gates. There are many versions of Windows. Windows 95, Windows 2000, Windows XP, and Windows NT. Now, let's see the various versions of OS. OS means operating system. So, as I told, OS is a master program. That means it supports the whole system. It controls the function of the computer. And as we know, without the OS, even we cannot start our computer. So, we can see now some of the example of operating system. And some of the operating systems are DOS, Disk Operating System, Windows, Unix, Linux. We generally use Windows operating system in our lab, offices and homes, because Windows operating system is more user friendly. We can see the various icons of Windows on the screen. These are the components of Windows: desktop, taskbar, date and time, wallpaper, start buttons, screen saver. You can be more explained by the following diagram. Even when you start your computer, you can see the various components which are available. As we know that start button is the leftmost corner, means it available in the leftmost corner and start button is shown on the screen also. We have various program buttons. We can see taskbar. Taskbar, it appears in the bottom of the screen. You can see the notification icon where all the notification comes here. You can see the various desktop gadgets also. You can see various desktop icons. Desktops, again I tell you, it appears very first time. When we start our computer, the first screen appears, that is a desktop screen. Desktop. Now, how the desktop looks like? Desktop looks, we can see the screen that appears first with Windows booted computer is called desktop. Means after when we start our computer, we can see it is appears at very first. You can see the various icons, menus, folders and items of taskbar like date and time, volume means volume control, etc. As we know children, icon is the symbol how we start and how we identify the program. Folder also, we can keep some of the files here. Date and time, we can see date as well as time on the screen. We can even control the volume also. It is also available in the desktop. Now, children, you can see various icons which is present on the screen. You can even some of the examples I can give you. You can see the calculators, you can see some of the folders, you can see music, paint, you can see the calendar, and you can see various DVD burn or CD. Means these are the symbols or these are the icons we can easily identify the program. Now children, let's go for icons. As I told you now, icons are the pictorial representation. It is the pictorial representation of program and other folders. An icon also be the symbol of some application software. And when we click the icons, the application software can be selected and executed. Means, by using the icons, we can select the program and we can use the program. Now, children, taskbar. Taskbar, it is the horizontal bar appears at the bottom of desktop. And desktop has the list of program opened by Windows. We can switch between these programs by clicking the buttons on the taskbar. Beta thumbnail preview can be seen in the taskbar. So, it is very easier to see the icons. So, whenever we can start our program, easily we can see the icons in the taskbar and we can open our application. Start button. Start button, it is used to start the programs. Means Windows, it get loaded into the memory and the desktop appears. Now at the left side on the bottom of screen we can see the start button and the icons of the start button. It is easily you can see on the screen. Now one can open the list of other program by clicking here. The same button is also to shut down the computer properly. Now, let's go for date and time. Even when we work on the computer, we almost need to see the date and time. And it is available in the right side on the taskbar. It shows the current time of computer clock. One can get the date, day, and calendar by clicking the mouse pointer over here. Means when we click on date and time, you can see the date, time, as well as the day. By right click of the mouse button, the date and time can be updated if the display is not correct. That means if the date and time is changed, we can even change the date as well as time. Next is screen saver. Screen saver is the display of several images, pictures and designs. On the screen, it starts if your computer is idle for a specified time. So, as we know, after sitting a long time, we may need some break. So, when we leave the computer for some time, the computer, it displays the screen saver. It is easily set on our computer. It can be combination of several images, pictures and designs. We can select based upon our choice. And it will be look more beautiful, means we can even make the screen decorative way by using the screen saver. So, screen saver, when it is shows, means it starts when, if the computer is idle, means when we don't work on our computer for a specified time. Time will be specified here. Wallpaper is the background of the desktop. We can easily choose a nice photographs, sceneries, images as the wallpaper of desktop. Even we can choose our photograph. To change the scheme of a screensaver and wallpaper, we go to the setting. Means we need to go to settings by clicking on the start button, which is appear in the leftmost corner, that already I have shown in the previous slide. Here, select the menus of control panel. Easily we can see these in control panel. And now double click on the icon of display. Okay, you can see on the screen also, when you go to the control panel, you have various options: my theme, arrow theme, save theme. You have various things. In the bottom side, if you see, you can see the desktop background, Windows color, sound, screen saver. So choose the desktop background and you can easily change a new scheme setting here. You can also apply your own drawing as background. Means even you can change the wallpaper by your drawing some good photographs of yourself as the background on the desktop. It give a more personalized look to your Windows desktop. Now, this is about the part 1 of the chapter 4, which is working with Windows. Thank you for watching.